The thing that really brings me back is the honesty that we have between the members. The graciousness that some of the members offer to each of the other members is overwhelming. It's nice to be able to sit down, talk about life struggles and triumphs and your walk in faith with like-minded folks.
We know each other better on a spiritual level now. Knowing each other on that spiritual level obviously changes the relationship.
And it's ever since Reverend Peterson did the Bless Challenge a couple of years ago that has stuck with me in all parts of my life. And this was another extension of that Bless Challenge.
You know, the scriptures talk about the fact that when one person suffers, we all suffer. And when one person rejoices, we all rejoice. And in a small group, there is that sense of community and intimacy that you don't get in the larger body of the church. God's design for us is that we need to be part of a community. And so part of that design includes us being connected to other people with whom we can be intimate and with whom we can pray and support, care for them.
It became, well, let's take church home. Instead of getting a group of people we knew from MDPC, let's talk to some people that we live and see with on a social basis.
Well, I was nervous with anticipation right before our first meeting started. I got there a little bit early and was hoping everybody would come. And it just was interesting to see different women from different parts of my life come into the same room together.
Eat with your friends in the neighborhood, fellowship with your friends in the neighborhood, pray with your friends in the neighborhood. And that really stuck with us. And we always kind of had a vision that one day we would try and do something like that with our neighbors.
It was an opportunity to step out of our comfort zone, even in our first meeting. I mean, we were so happy that, you know, at the end that we had made the decision to come. You know, that's been a year now and we're still involved.
Sitting in a small group is where you can share your life experiences and talk through things and ask questions of each other that you unfortunately don't get to pause the worship service and ask Dave a question.
It just was such a blessing. I mean, I literally had goosebumps the entire time. I received so many emails after that first meeting of, I can't tell you how much I needed this. It's really been unbelievable.
You know, it worked despite all the obstacles. We decided on a day, we decided on a time, and then that changed a week prior, you know, and that's why we ended up starting 2 weeks late. But we made it work, and I would say that there's probably no obstacle that you can't overcome as far as scheduling.
You know, to be in fellowship, we're not meant to walk alone, and I think that has been the greatest gift of all.
Eat, Pray, Lent small groups will begin meeting the week of February 26th to study the new 5-week Lenten devotional guide, Why the Cross. There are two ways to get involved. Get a group of friends, neighbors, or your existing small group to register and use the devotional guide, or you can sign up to join one of the 9 open small groups for the series. To sign up today, stop by the Eat, Pray, Lent table in the Sanctuary Breezeway, or register online at register.mdpc.org.